in other times, we have people being able to afford housing because of mortgage. In Nigeria, looking back over the years, would you say that enough is being done about mortgage and enough information is available to Nigerians about how they can access mortgage?
We're giving the available structure or ground. Government is actually putting in place a number of platforms to be able to achieve that. That is why Federal Mortgage Bank is there as a secondary mortgage institution, and primary mortgage banks are equally set up in order to take advantage of the Federal Housing Fund. They have Federal Civil Service Loans Board equally in place to cater for housing needs. But be that as it may, taking in retrospect, you're going to find out that there was inadequate flow of information. So a good number of people never knew the existence of the mortgage platform that was put in place. Apart from the deficient or the state of deficiency in the flow of information, it was equally bewildered with bureaucratic bottlenecks. So having to go through the process of packaging. Packaging, as it were, is another big word. It takes a lot to come out to arrive at what packaging is about. But I'm sure in the course of the program, we'll be able to let the viewers understand what it means to say one is being packaged on the basis of mortgage.
Now, can you give us a background for Pujo Shelters Limited?
Well, Pujo Shelter is an answer to one of such numerous challenges or questions arising from mortgage and real estate development in Nigeria. As a mortgage banker, I found myself more or less as a striker who ran a drought of goals. You know, there were a number of people to be really financed, given the available finances. But the scarcity of unavailable houses to meet up with the available finance as it were then. So it then means that a lot needed to be done in generating the houses. So that was the thought of that actually gave rise to the thinking of Pujo Shelters. And again, an answer to the bureaucratic bottlenecks was associated with the whole sector. We are here to make a statement by way of demystifying the process of housing ownership in Nigeria. How does this thinking go? One, we have to let the public know that you don't become a landlord only when you have bought yourself a house. You become a landlord from that day you bought yourself a land. And I want to equally add that no bank will give you money to go, will lend you money to go and buy a land. But should you have a land, it's a beginning. So you can have various financial institutions, either giving formal or informal sector, coming to be part of what you are doing. So that is one of our thinkings. Then, to equally reorientate the minds of people, that it is no use really rejoicing over being a tenant in highbrow areas or being a squatter in highbrow area, rather than working towards owning your own house, no matter how small. It could be within the satellite area that you can call your own. I think what a place we call satellite town today may become the hub of the town or the city tomorrow. So the idea that it must be Amak, where a land will be sold for 50 million or thereabout. So what? Why go for 50 million for a plot when 10 million naira or less can give you a bungalow that you can be proud of in the suburb or satellite towns, and an environment devoid of high risk. Environment devoid of high risk. So we try to identify with areas where, when you are keen to buying a land, buying to a process of being built for, or create a platform created for you to build on your own, you have peace. And that is one of the things that is one of the points we have been able to score. When you align with us, come son, come re, knock on our door, day or night, you meet us and we are able to advise you. That is the statement we have come to make to ensure that the housing issue in Nigeria is addressed, at least from our own point of view. I'm sure if we all should deal with a common issue, that is focusing on those who really need these houses, who really need these properties, if our attention is really focused on them, then we'll be addressing the issue of the housing deficiency in Nigeria.
Now, some people think that you actually need to have all the money in the world before you go into building a house. What category of people do you cater for?
More interested, giving the low income earners and the medium income earners. That is because they are the most hit. The high network individuals, they already have their own interest here or there. What they are out to achieve beyond there is just for ostentation. Those having ostentatious taste. But these people really need to be taken out of the shanty, be polished, to be made to live a normal life. So I want to tell you that, given my experience, I know that what has been the biggest challenge to them is been knowledge gap. So that knowledge gap is what we are here to fill. It is very possible for you to own your own house, irrespective of how much you are earning. But you have to call a spade, know where to go to. For instance, what we do, we go deep down to initiate the process of land acquisition up to the root, then taking it to the government level, from the local to the government level, having it properly profiled and documented in order to make it relevant, you know. So, although it is a very rigorous process, and that is why we have been very, very thankful to our teaming clients out there for being patient in with us in taking the process through the normal process is supposed to take, you know, and that would have amounted to spending a little more than the expected time. But however, we are matching our words with our actions now, because gradually everyone is being attended to. So we have a number of people, institutions, who are applauding that feat on our part. For instance, the Medical Health Workers Union of National Hospital, they are major beneficiaries. They've been able to acquire a good number of plots from us, from Gwagwalada Aziz. What they felt that anybody could think wouldn't be able to happen, but it happened, and they are proud landowners today, and they are happy with us, and it is giving the huge success of that experience that made them to come to us again and say they need further services from us. So we are not really here to theorize, but we are here to testify that yes, with little money you earn, a salary earner, you'll be able to acquire yourself a land, you'll be able to work towards realizing the dream of owning yourself a home.
Okay, now somebody out there listening to us is asking himself how he can be part of this. So for instance, if I want to get a house through Pujo now, how do I go about it?
Well, we open, we create a level playing field for all who want to be part of what we're doing. One, if you want to own a land in our estate, we can, if you don't have the money to pay outrightly, we structure in such a way to meet up with your strength on an instrumental basis. So that is one phase. After the acquisition, we ask, do you want to build for yourself or you want us to build for you? The choice is also yours. So there are some who would want to say, look, we are here, we believe in what you're doing, we want to build for our cooperative. We are not coming as individual, but we are coming as a body. Just as we have the Medical and Health Workers Unions now, they are saying, we want you to build for us. And to that effect, they have given us their secretariat inside the National Hospital. We now have a satellite office there to be able to pursue the realization of such. That is because it is done before, and it's going to happen again. Then we equally have the NCCE, the National Commission for Colleges of Education, their union. A good number of them equally keyed in, and they believe in what we are doing, and they are testifiers. So we equally have the cooperative of Dar Communication, a good number of them acquired through their cooperative from us, and it's been a very good one. Apart from general individuals, we can't begin to mention names, but it's only suffice to say that institutions are big enough to be mentioned. So that's why we are mentioning institutions. So when you come to us, we open the array of opportunities. So the choice will definitely not be yours. Ours is to provide you with the needed information. The decision is yours.
Talking about the array of possibilities, I would like you to tell us, do you have specific packages on ground now that people can key into, specific projects of which people can be a part of?
Sure. We have two estates. One is in Karachi, the other one is along Abuja Kefir Road. Funny enough, our brothers and sisters in diaspora, they are, the news has reached them, and they are coming to take advantage of what we are doing. So we have two essays running, and more are underway. We are working on the documentation, the process. So the general public is welcome.
Okay. Now I want you to give us an actual pricing. What's the minimum that one can start up with you people to be able to get a house?
Well, there are areas of them. One, you could initiate a process of parting with your instrumental payments to us, and you monitor your house as it grows. Two, if you are a contributor to the National Housing Fund, we have a mortgage banker we are working with, and that mortgage banker is FHA Mortgage Bank. So anyone who is interested in going through the window of the mortgage bank, we present a position. One, the requirements will be that you must be a contributor to the National Housing Fund for not less than a period of 6 months. And that means 2.5% of your basic salary is remitted to Federal Mortgage Bank. That qualifies you, whether you are in a formal sector or a new formal sector. Then there must be a verifiable source of income on your part. Then you would have been, at the end of the day, when accessibility is carried out, affordability, when it is carried out on you based on what you are earning, vis-a-vis, if you are a public servant, the number of years you have in service comes to play. If your age is 40 years, for instance, and your retirement age is 60, then 40 away from 60, you are left with 20 years when it comes to going through the part of service years. Then the number of years you have put into service, if it is 25 years you are put into service, you are going to minus 25 years from your retirement. So whichever one that comes first is what is taken as a as your tenor of repayment. So in this hypothetical position, you see that it's going to be 20 years, which is coming from the point of view of the age. So taking into consideration also labor law that has respect for human dignity, by the time access affordability is processed, it is expected that not more than 1/3 of your salary or your income as a TWI, as a salary earner, is deducted from your salary to enable you meet up. So if 1/3 of what you earn is able to take you through the repayment through the 20 years as hypothetically put, it means you are qualified for that particular scheme you are going in for. But I have always said, giving an informed position, people don't need to get scared when they say they are 1/3 of their contribution may not be able to take them through. They shouldn't get scared, because when you have other verifiable source of livelihood or income, it doesn't matter whether you are a public servant or not. You could, your parents or anybody could leave you with an estate. It does not require that you must engage yourself in other kind of job that will make you to that will make anybody feel that you are not faithful to where you are working as a government person. No, you could have an estate where you are having extra income from. So even when you are going to retire in 10 years and your external sources of income, which is subject to verification, if it is proven to be so, that you have the capacity to so repay, why not? So let people not get scared on the ground that they are close to retirement. But let them look back. Do you have other sources of income that is verifiable, that can take care of writing up the loan, that can give you an insight?
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, now let's look at the time of delivery. Part of the problem some people have had is that it takes a very long period of time for these kind of projects to be actualized. We've had complaints in the past of some people keen into projects and several years down the line, nothing is available to show for it. So working with Pujo, what is the time frame within which one can reasonably expect that the houses will be delivered?
Yeah, before narrowing it down to Pujo, let me deal with a general issue as it relates to the workings. Now, remember, the pool of fund that constitutes a common fund for people to draw from, that is warehoused by the Federal Mortgage Bank. That pool of fund is now being overstretched. Many hands are now chasing that pool of funds. So, whereas under normal condition, someone who met with the various requirements, under normal condition, it was not supposed to be more than 4 months for such a loan to be perfected and be disbursed. But I sympathize with the Federal Mortgage Bank, because what the fund they have to contend with, a great number of people who have come to the knowledge of its existence now, It's so much that it is scarcely enough to go around. So you have many people being on the queue. So that is a serious situation. Then you have some few financial houses who want to say they want to do mortgage. But ironically, what they call mortgage is really not mortgage. How will you say somebody, how will you expect someone to take a short-term loan to deal with a long-term loan facility? But narrowing it now to Kojo Shelters, what is the time frame? So we're trying to educate our uptakers, the need for us to appreciate the economic reality on ground. You don't have the money, so to speak, to take a giant stride. Even those of us in the real estate sector, especially those of us who are going through the normal process, we don't have all the money in the world to play around with. It's okay. Let us work at a pace that no one gets hurt, no one gets choked. So, if we are saying we provide a plot of land for you, the land is there, the infrastructure is put in place, we now ask you, are you building for yourself? So if you are going to build for yourself, that question will no longer come to us. How long? The question now will now be, the one who wants to build for himself, how long do you want to build? But for those who will say they want us to build for them, we still ask ourselves the question, what is your strength? At what pace do we go? So we have a very clear working understanding with our clients. So all that we need to do is to create a platform for us to move together as a family. But I must confess, the journey has been rough. But the joy is that every step we take takes out. And we will not misinform. We will not misinform our clients to let them know that the mortgage arrangement that will probably take more than a year, sometimes 2 years, we will not misinform our clients to say, if you take a mortgage, if you are packing now for mortgage, that don't worry, in the next 4 months, 6 months, your mortgage will be no. We let them know. So we don't have to just get the market today. What happens to our integrity? So it is a holistic thing. The network, the various stakeholders, the role they need to play, especially in the housing industry, it is interdependent. So if the mortgage, anyone coming from the point of view of mortgage, if we are guaranteed to have, if we are guaranteed to have on packaging, given a period of 6 months, why not? Our speed will be faster too. Then we try as much as possible, like I initially mentioned, not to expose our clients to where they will get hooked up, a situation where they will not be able to move forward. So we try to avoid that. Then, okay.
No,
yes, when it comes to our the prices of our estate. I will always say, because it is dynamic, we are on promo now. We have, it ranges from 400 to 600. It depends on giving the promo prices.
Is that for the land?
For the land, yes. For the land.
And then how about building? What's the cheapest price for building?
We have for 3.2 million. We have the one for 5 million. We have the one for 7 million. We have the one for 2 million, 9 million, as the case may be.
Okay.
Yes. Quite friendly.
Now, on a parting note, what is your message out there for those who have listened to us today?
Yeah. I want to assure the investing public that